Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. You are watching Saturday Study Talks on my channel Best Way to Study. In this video, I am going to answer all your questions. Every Saturday, I will be answering all your questions, questions related to education, career guidance, even personal questions. So let's begin our video. Coming to the first question, Sudeep Kudari. I have studied first PU in one college and second PU in another college. So is it compulsory to issue study certificate from both the colleges? I have only one study certificate from the second college. Okay, so as you are telling, Sudeep Kudari, as you're telling that you've studied from two different colleges, from second college you'll be having study certificate. And coming to first college, you at least, like, if you don't have study certificate, at least you take the transfer certificate or NOC, some related certificate also with you, which is related to the first PU college, like the first college also. Second college, take the study certificate from first college. At least you have to carry NOC or transfer certificate, any certificate related to the first college also, okay? So coming to the second question is from Shamaira Naz. Okay, so coming to Shamaira Naz, she is saying, I have scored 58 marks in TS. So coming to Shamaira Naz, I have scored 58 marks in TS Lawset. Can my admission be taken in any of the government college? Please tell, is there any possibility to take admission in OU? Okay, so Shamaira Naz, as you have written TS Lawset and you got 58 marks in TS Lawset, you didn't mention your rank and your caste, because admission in government colleges and admission in the topmost universities such as OU, for that I need to know your reservation category. Are you from reservation category, and as well as your rank? So I'm just telling the cutoff of Osmania University category wise as well as caste wise. So with that, you can just compare the rank you scored and the cutoff of Osmania University. So coming to the open category male, the cutoff rank should be 25. Okay, so the rank should be below 25 for the admission of University College of Law, Osmania University. Coming to the open category of female, you should get the rank below 20 to 25. And coming to BC, you should get rank below 60. Coming to SC, you should get rank below 85. Coming to ST, you should get the rank below 90. So based upon that, just compare your rank as well as the Osmania University cutoff so that you know whether you can get admission through OU or not. Okay, so now let's see next question. Next question is from Venki Vallapuda. Okay, Venki Vallapudas. Okay, so Naku 58 state rank 2191. Naku 58 means I think your marks are 58. State rank, oh, you got state rank of 2191. Caste is SC, government college low, chance seat Ostunda. Okay, so as you got the rank 2000. So you got the rank about 2000. So I'm going to tell you few colleges where you can get the admission for your rank. So let me tell a few best colleges with the rank 2000. So let's see. Coming to rank 2000, you can get admission into the College of Adarsha Law College, which is in Warangal. They will take your admission. Ananta Law College, which is in Hyderabad. You can get admission in that college for your rank. Even the few colleges like Aurora Legal Science Academy, you can even get college admission of Aurora, and Bhaskara Law College, and Dr. Ambedkar College. Even in Mahatma Gandhi Law College, you can get admission because they accept the ranks till 7,000 also. Coming to few more colleges, you can get Justice Kumaraya Law College, which is in Karimnagar. You can get admission in that college also. As your SC, you have the chances of getting even in government colleges. So you can also get the admission in Kesav Memorial College of Law, which is in Hyderabad, and KV Ranga Reddy Institute. So you know there are many opportunities for you because you have got really good rank. So all the best for you, Winky. So coming to next question, Ganesh Jallarapu. Okay, so during the certificate verification, shall we have to submit our original certificates? Because I have applied for two more PG programs. Do they take all my originals during the process of counseling? Okay, so hi Ganesh, coming to counseling, the thing is they don't take your certificates, they just verify your certificates. Okay, once you give them the certificates, they'll verify and return them back to you. They just take and accept only, they just keep Xerox copies of original certificates with them. Original certificates they'll give you there itself after verification. They just ask you original certificate just for verification. They will not take and keep your original certificates. You can apply for PG programs, no problem. But make sure you take 2 to 3 copies of Xerox copies of the original certificates, and you know that 2 to 3 copies they will take, and in counseling they'll just put for themselves. Okay, so make sure you have you carry at least 2 to 3, maximum like maximum 5, minimum 2. Okay, 2 to 5 copies of Xerox copies of your educational certificate you have to carry when you go to counseling. So if it is online counseling, then you have to have the scanned copy of the Xerox of the original certificate. They will not keep themselves, they'll just return you back as soon as the counseling process is finished, coming to original certificate. So don't worry. Coming to Anusha Chaudhary, ma'am, when will be the second counseling held for the engineering stream? Okay, so coming to the second counseling of NSET, it will be in the month of July, last week, or in August. It depends, because you know NSET results have been recently released. So in June, first counseling will happen. In July or in August, first week, second counseling will be there. So all the best, Anusha. So coming to next question, is from Shiva Kumar. Ma'am, we have two sets Xerox, right? On we need to attest. Okay, so okay, Shiva Kumar, you should take two sets of the Xerox copies. No, he's asking, ma'am, we have to take two sets Xerox copies. Do we need to attest it on the seal? So the thing is, don't attest anything on the seal. Just take the Xerox copies and keep it with you. Once the officials or once the counseling people ask you to do any process, just then go for it. Otherwise, don't attest anything or don't do anything with your Xerox. Just keep it with you safely, okay? So coming to next question is from Durga Prasad. Hi ma'am, I scored 1240 rank. in TS Lawset, which college I could expect. So 1,240 rank is really good. If you are under reserved category, you're going to get a college admission for the topmost colleges as well as government universities as well. Almost in all the colleges, you're going to get the admissions. If you're SC or ST, you're going to get the even government colleges, you'll be admitted. Like in government colleges and government universities, also you'll be getting admission. It's very good rank. Congratulations. So, coming to next question, and all the best, Durga Prasad. So, coming to next question is from Venki again. Naku, 3 years. Okay, I answered this question. So, Venki, I already answered your question. You asked the same question twice. I already answered your question. So, coming to next question, it is from Sai Kumar. Hello, madam. I am a government employee. I have got 58 marks and 2,289 rank. Is there any chance to do LLB in distance or any evening college available? So, coming to Sai Kumar Garu, you're already a government employee. I think you can happily go for LLB in distance, but the thing is, make sure you choose a good college, because most of the times there will be less value for the education which is done in distance. So make sure, as you got 58 marks and 2000, like, it's a good rank. So make sure you select a college where you, instead of going to evening colleges, you can do it at a distance. But doing LLB in distance will be really good if you start studying in a good college. Okay, if you study in a good college, so first what you need to do is choose best college. So then if you do LLB in distance also, your resume, like your educational value will be really high. Your educational certificate will give a lot of value. Okay, so choosing the best college is really important thing. All the best, Sai Kumar. So coming to next question, last educational related question. So next, there are personal questions. So coming to last educational related question, it is from Bulal Royal. So I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing the names. I'm sorry, Bulal Royal. Where should we pay counseling fee? Okay, so counseling fee, they'll officially declare the dates. Then in those dates, you have to register yourself for counseling, and then you have to pay the counseling fee for according to your caste, because for different categories, for different caste, there are different fees. Okay, for SCST there will be relatively low fees, and for unreserved category there will be high fees. So you have to pay your counseling fees once they officially announce the counseling dates, and you first, after they've declared the counseling dates officially, you need to register yourself. First of all, you need to register yourself for counseling, and then you have to follow all the processes. Like, they'll be asking you to fill a form. You have to fill that form and then pay the counseling fee according to your reservation or unreservation. And after that, you'll be asked to fill another application form regarding which college you would like to get admitted into and which course you are interested in, all those stuff. So after that, you can go for first counseling. So till now we have done with the educational related questions. Now let's see personal questions. So this week I've selected only two personal questions. That's it. I'm sorry for the people whose questions I didn't select, even educational related questions, like only few questions I've selected. So coming to personal questions, I've selected only two questions this week. So coming to first question. Okay. I'm not reading out the names for personal questions. Okay. I'm just reading out the question and I'll answer. Okay. So coming to the first personal question. What is the life of a YouTuber? Okay. So what is the life of a YouTuber? Okay, first of all, I would like to tell the differences between, before being a YouTuber and after being a YouTuber, there's a lot of changes in my life. Coming to my life personally, there are a lot of changes. Before being a YouTuber, I used to just be for myself, my life, just used to be just my things. But now, most of the day, 3/4 of the day, I'm spending just for you people, making content, selecting the subject, editing the videos, coming to my schedule. Not only my schedule, most of the YouTubers, I especially, I'll start editing my videos till night 1, 2 also sometimes. Minimum 8 to 10 hours I'll be working on YouTube just to release 2 to 3 videos a day. It takes me almost more than a half of a day. So first of all, I start my work at morning 8 o'clock mostly. By 8, I'll just prepare the content. I'll just prepare the concept of the video and content of the video. And I'll also decide what all videos to upload today. So after that, I'll record the video. I'll make a video first of all. After that, I'll create the thumbnails. Thumbnails means the picture which you can see beside my video. You'll click on that, right? And then my video comes, so that is called thumbnail. So I'll make video first content, then thumbnail, then I'll just think of the title. Okay, what title should be apt, what is the apt title for the video and the content. So after these three things, I'll start editing my video. Editing means I'll first of all I'll upload the video, I'll then edit the video, add audio if required. Most of the videos will have audios, and very few will have my recording voice. So after that, I'll just add the end screen and subtitles if required. Subsequently, under this my video, subscribe, that all that those are called subtitles. So I'll enter that subtitles, and there'll be a notes. Even I should edit that notes. Notes matlab, when you watch my video, in between, in like suggestions, some videos will be displayed like on the topmost right side. You can observe in my video, in this video as well. So all that editing will be done. So especially for editing, for particular video, editing will take 45 to 50 minutes minimum. So, and I also choose the questions which I need to answer. Okay, for example, every Saturday I'll be answering your questions. So from Sunday itself, I'll be choosing the questions because there'll be lots and lots of comments. I may miss out some useful question, or I may miss out some helpful question. If I answer that, many of the students may be, it may help many of the students who are having similar questions. So every day I collect questions from the comment section, for the Saturday study talks, and I also choose the questions, few questions from personal questions as well. Personal questions, like viewers asking personal questions. Some people will be commenting like, we want that video, we want this video. I try myself the most to make all the videos which my viewers and subscribers ask, but time is not permitting nowadays because I'm working hard for 8 to 10 hours. But still, there's a lot of work for me to do. At present, I have approximately 300 videos which I need to do, but there's no time. So according to the priorities and according to viewers demand, I keep selecting my videos, like what video to do, what video to upload, and all that. So I have lots and lots, like approximately 50 of my viewers have requested me to start spoken English classes, but I would love to do it, but time is not permitting. I'm trying my level best. Yesterday I was not feeling well. Even now I have a severe headache, but still I don't want to miss out the Saturday study talks video, so I came here. That's why I selected only two personal questions. So that's it. That's the life of a YouTuber. And what makes me happy is, positive comments, views, and all that. And the strange thing about videos is that if I upload a video thinking it has high demand, I'll get most of the views, there'll be really less views. If I upload the video randomly and if I expect like most of the people may not watch, I'll get thousands and thousands of views. So that's the strange thing about the YouTube. So coming to the last personal question. Apart from YouTube, what do you do in a day? Nice question. Apart from YouTube, I take rest. And because working system, like minimum 8 hours I'll be watching the system. So I want to take rest. So most of the time I'll be taking rest. I love spending time with the and like you know Like I love rainy seasons and spending time with the climate, environment, and all. So if I feel that it's a rainy climate and the cloudy climate, I just go out to the terrace and I enjoy myself. And environment, I just love the like nature and the environments and all. I try to spend most. I don't go out much, but I just love spending time with environment and nature. I sit outside the home and I keep observing things and all. So and I do read comments, okay? Whenever I don't have YouTube work, I do read many and many comments. I read all the comments and I try replying people because I don't want to hurt even one of my subscriber or viewer. So, and most of the videos I'll try my level best to make. Like, if you ask me to do a video, I'll try my level best to make. So, most of the viewers ask me to do video on APM set, TSM set, E set, and all. I tried all the things and I did it and uploaded it finally. So, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. Like and share this video with all your friends. If you have any videos, if you want me to do any videos, if you have any queries, and if you have any personal questions to ask me, or if you want any study related questions, or if you have any career guidance questions, and something is like that, you can feel free to comment me. I'll answer all your questions in the coming Saturday in Saturday study talks. And last but not least, recent Telangana inter issue which was happened, I was very sad for that, for the like all the students who lost their life. I was really sad for that. So I came up with an initiative that is, if students, like few students who feel depressed during exams, or who feel like they lost confidence during exams, something like that, and who are having nobody to share their feelings about the depression and disappointment, and who faced a lot of failures in their life, all the people, all the students are welcome. So you people can happily mail your sadness, sorrows to my mail, bestwaytostudy7@gmail.com. I am with you, so please don't end up taking any wrong decisions. You have to live. You are on this earth with some cause, so please don't end up things just for small things. you have to live happily 100 years. Don't take wrong decisions just for one issue or something like that. So make sure if you have any sadness or if you have any problems, I'll give you the answer. Like, as per my knowledge, what am I thinking? Like, related to that, I'm with you. I'll give you solutions for your problems, not a professional solutions, but I am with you always. So if you have any disturbances in your life, or if you have any sorrows, sadness, disappointments, failures, or depressions, feel free to mail me all your problems. So I'll reply you. Mail address is in the comment section below, in the description below. Best way to study 7@gmail.com. And for India's best CRT training and India's best online Java training as well as AWS training, you must try this setyourrank.com, which is in the link is in the subscription description below. I'm getting confused with the subscription and the description. Okay, go and go to the description and make sure you register yourself, because it is one of the bestest and affordable. It's just 499 rupees, online training, and the batches are from morning to night. Whenever you are comfortable, you can register for those ba that batch. So all the best, and thanks for watching. Subscribe, hit the bell icon for more such videos. Like and share this video. Thanks for watching.